I think it's best to start with my father's New Year's Eve party. His party to celebrate the beginning of the new century. At least we all thought it was the beginning of the new century. My father was Romanian by birth, but had arrived as a young man in Scotland, where he brought us all up after the death of my mother, before bringing us and his building contractor's business down south to this horrible little town outside London. It was full of suspicious, nosy people. It is difficult to convey how much I was really dying to leave home.
Mr. Reisner! You can't do that! We told you you can't! Take it down at once! What on earth do you think you're doing?
What am I doing? Celebrating! It looks rather good, don't you think so? A new electrical sign. People will see it for miles.
But this is not your land. Did you listen to the council resolution? We told you again and again that we're celebrating next year in this town. The century doesn't start till next year. Everybody agrees.
Next year.
Paul, come here quickly. You've got to come and see this now. Come on. Now. Come on.
I am sorry to disagree with you gentlemen, but I am going to have a party now.
Oh my God, they're not going to pull it down, are they?
And I am extremely proud of this sign, and I will not move it.
We have to enforce the wishes of the town, and this isn't your land.
I don't understand. It's New Year's Eve 1899. That must mean the end of the century. How can it not be?
Because they say you're not 1 year old until your first birthday, so the century is not 100 until next year.
That's stupid.
A lot of countries have decided to celebrate next year.
But not Papa.
Not Papa.
Why on earth are you celebrating New Year anyway? This is not your New Year. Your New Year is different because of your religion, isn't that so?
But I am also a Scotsman, as you may know. And no Scotsman ever did not celebrate New Year's Eve.
We're going to have another meeting about this, Mr. Reisner, I warn you.
I will see you tonight, gentlemen. You all have your invitations, do you? Till tonight. But there is 15 minutes to go before midnight. The toast. Welcome, 1900.
Bravo.
A new year, a new century, and a new start for our little town.
No speech, Papa.
And also a celebration of my son, Paul. My doctor son, who is joining the new pioneering medical research institution. To be world famous soon, I hope. And by God, we are going to give him a tremendous farewell tomorrow. Especially after tonight. A carriage and 6 horses.
Not 6, Papa.
Welcome anyway, even if you aren't a new century. Whatever you are, you certainly taste good. Papa has bought a telephone.
So I see.
He means to begin this year in style.
I don't know why you are sneaking out of the town like this. It is absolutely wrong.
I'm not sneaking out. It's best this way. You wanted to hold your party, and I want to leave as simply as possible, so goodbye, Papa.
It is not the farewell I had planned for you. I have already booked the 6 horses. Look at this ridiculous vehicle.
No, it's absolutely fine. There's plenty of room.
I'm ready, driver. Drive on. Come on.
Then walk a little way. And remember, ring me whenever you like.
Yes, Papa. Can you not go any faster?
I won't give you any advice, because you can look after yourself. But remember, if you go out at night, go armed. With at least a sword stick.
I'm only going to London, Papa.
No. There are at least 4 murders a night there. And always carry a sharp stone in your pocket that is highly recommended, so you can rush out with it if you are attacked.
Don't worry. I'll keep an eye on.
Glad you could come to the party the other evening. You missed something special.
Shh. They're not worth it.
I won't say don't let me down, because I know that is impossible. Quite impossible, but just be the best, and why shouldn't you be? The absolute best, and then you will be a success!
Looking so pleased about.
He's saving on his travel, isn't he?
Is this it? What is it, hospital?
No. It's a new institute which has opened here. There are no patients, only doctors and volunteers.
Volunteers? Really? Let us know if they need a telephone.
Come on, boys, walk on. Dr. Reisner. I have come.
You're early. Not expected until tomorrow.
I apologize. Can I see my room?
Clara? This is the old hospital wing. Mind the puddle.
I think there must be some mistake. A mistake here. I am Dr. Reisner. I am not...
Not what?
Not a patient or a volunteer.
We hadn't realized you're not a volunteer, believe it or not. You're Dr. Reisner. And this is Dr. Reisner's bed. And these are all the other little doctor's beds. Well, there's nothing useful you can do here. Clara will unpack. You'll find the others across the street. You can talk about your bed to them if you like.
Good afternoon, I'm Dr. Reisner. Are you doctors? You're not. Doctors. Sorry, I'm looking for the doctors from the Whiteweather Institute.
No, we're the doctors.
Not wasting a moment, is he?
Bacteriology.
Cardiology.
Physiology. Humoral science.
Physiology, humoral science.
Oh, good, you too.
Yes. Physiology, cardiology, bacteriology, pathology, and a little rheumatic fever thrown in as well. He doesn't believe me.
Not yet, no.
I'm Felix Russell. Don't worry, we'll get you some clothes. Because you're absolutely naked like that, aren't you? You know how research is regarded. Well, I don't know what they think of it where you come from, wherever that might be. But here in London, it's regarded as the lowest form of life. Because medicine's an art, you see, not some sordid science where people work in laboratories with machines. Machines! Ooh, that's so vulgar!
So if we look magnificent, it helps.
It's a necessity.
Quite an enjoyable necessity.
Yes. We can't afford to use the whole building yet. One day it will be full. It's the best train set anybody ever had to play with. Nice now. Are you Jewish? Makes no difference to me. I just wanted to know.
Yes, I am. Whose laboratory is this?
Mine, of course. That's yours over there. Well, nobody knows how good you are, you see, so you get the smallest.
Things can always change, I assume.
Well, we'll see. It's an electrical chair that turns into a horseless carriage. You can join up with your friends, each in a chair, and ride six abreast down the street. I collect them. Everybody's selling them this year, models of machines of the future.
Who gets the little room?
Oh, we all do. Once a week. You have to wait a little longer, though.
Oh, it ain't very private in here, is it?
Oh, well. You're all doctors. You all know what a lady looks like.
Well, I hope you do.
This gentleman I went to visit, he was an officer.
Maybe I shouldn't say that.
Anyway, he had a few rude words to say about doctors, but then two of his brothers died last year.
Welcome to the Institute.
It's an honor, sir. I didn't realize you were there.
Don't be silly. It's not an honor to be woken at this hour. I just wanted to catch you before you began your first day. There is only one thing you have to realize about being here. You are free. There is no firm structure, no daily supervision. You follow your instincts, if you have them. You decide how to spend your time, and I judge the results. Which may happen at any time, I warn you. I remember your interview. Physiology. Much to find out there. No need to wish you good luck. Of course, you are here on a temporary basis only. Until I decide otherwise.
This is your laboratory assistant, James. Russell, me and you share him. He works for all of us, remember that.
Is this your first day?
Yes.
Don't worry. He's surprisingly good at his job.
They come here because nobody else can help them.
Can you show me what you've been telling me?
Excuse me.
Who gave you this?
It doesn't matter. Never, never take this again. It'll do more harm than good. I need some alkaline solution. And some thyroid extract. And hurry, please. Oh, it's you. I didn't realize you worked here. I thought...
I make the beds. I do make the beds. 3 times a week.
But you shouldn't, should you? Do both.
You worried I'm a health risk, sir? You want to make your own bed in the future. I promise I won't object if that's what you want.
I'll consider the offer and let you know.
You do realize it can be very dangerous here. The risk of infection is extremely high. You must make sure you keep everything as clean as possible. You understand, including yourself.
Yes, thank you, sir. I did wash myself thoroughly before unpacking your luggage, sir, so you shouldn't catch anything, you see. At least not from me.
Good. That's reassuring.
Which is more than he will.
This is a pancreatic extract to treat the diabetes. Now, don't worry, young man. Look at the ceiling. This will stop you losing your sugar. But look at the ceiling.
Are you mad? What do you think you're doing? You can't inject him with that.
These are my volunteers. This is my treatment. You must never interfere with a colleague's work here. Do you understand?
You can't do that. It can do him immense damage.
Oh. What on earth do you think you were doing, Reisner? Assaulting a colleague? This has never happened before.
He was giving the wrong treatment, sir, which could have been fatal in my view. The idea that you can inject untreated pancreatic extract is totally discredited.
There's a call on the telephone for this gentleman.
I won't take it now, thank you. Tell the party. I'll telephone them later, please.
No, you may as well take it now. I've nothing further to say to you.
Yes, Papa, what is it?
How on earth did you know who it was?
Who else could it have been? What do you want?
What do I want? To know how you're getting on.
Give me some details, Paul. Details.
This is not a good moment, Papa.
Details, Paul.
For 1 minute.
Details.
Be quiet.
I can't hear you.
Everything's very good.
But this is just about the worst moment of the day, so I have to go. I'm sorry, I have to go now.
Everything is splendid. And the telephone works over this long distance, too.
Yes, Papa. I wish one didn't have to shout so much when one uses it.
Gentlemen! No hard feelings about the sign, I hope. Not here, anyway. And I am sure that absolutely normal relations can be resumed. You see, everything.
Poor Edwin.
No, I mean it.
Why? He was no good, so now he's gone. That's the way it works here.
Gonna be after me next. Gonna be exciting between you and me, Reisner. You're so ambitious!
Of course. This is an amazing place to be, Felix. But I'm not at all sure I'm safe yet.
You're not. Nearly.
James.
Yes, sir.
This is a very indelicate matter, but I'm going to broach you all the same while I'm still here. You know the room? The cubicle. Well, it's my turn tonight.
Yes, I was wondering when you'd ask me about that.
I was thinking you might know a companion. A female who...
It's funny, isn't it? Everybody's talking about sex at the moment. You know, last year there were 2,000 pamphlets published on heterosexual activities, sexual habits among the different classes.
Yes, that's very instructive, James, and no doubt I'll be reading them, but they're not much use.
I may know someone, yes.
Maybe. So what do I do?
You want me to do everything, sir?
Not everything, no, only the difficult part.
You have to take her out, or at least a walk.
Do I pay her? Will she expect that?
Hello? It's for you, Reisner.
Papa. Papa, listen, it is wonderful to hear from you, but I do have some urgent business to attend to.
One on the left is in the middle of her period and is having great difficulty with the towel.
Felix, please, there is company present.
Thank you, Dr. Reisner, but I'm interested. Do you think they'll find an easier way of dealing with women's periods?
Well, it must happen. Ladies going out now during their periods, it's an incredibly perilous business making sure nobody sees anything. Now, somebody must come up with a better sanitary invention. It's just because nobody's applied themselves to it.
Is that what you're working on then, Felix, your private schemes?
No, certainly not. Not yet. You said I was working on anything anyway. You can't know everything, Reisner.
A leading figure in medical science who'd already done brilliant work by the time he was our age.
The first person to employ women as laboratory assistants. Even a black man.
Really?
This evening, are you busy this evening?
Busy? Hmm?
Really working, isn't
it? Not particularly.
Can we meet, do you think?
Do you mean meet?
I thought we would just meet.
Meet? Where?
Well, if you didn't go home after work, I could take you for a meal and,
And what? Suddenly not worried about infection anymore.
Go on, Clara. Lady of experience.
I do just mean for a meal. We could have a feast and then we could...
And then I'd be walked through the little cubicle, would I? You know, it may seem strange and old-fashioned, but... I think I prefer meals I don't have to pay for.
We don't need any of this. Wild animal extract. No. This is quackery. If you're going to wear gloves to do that work, it is advisable for them not to have holes.
Sir? Sir! Sir, you're late for your appointment. The widow, the patroness. Can you remember? She has enormous power over what happens to people here.
Oh, my God.
The quickest way out is that way.
What?
It's a shortcut. I promise. Go on. It's by far the best way out.
Thank you.
my deepest apologies.
Please. Are they all as young as you?
I'm not that young.
My husband imagined, I'm very sure, men with beards. When he left the money to fund the Institute, he meant there to be distinguished professors, like in Germany, with beards. But instead, there's one professor and a lot of little boys.
Well, it's a new field, a whole new science, so...
A science, is it?
Their inherited characteristics produce better people. Practice what we call the science of eugenics. And if so, how can we achieve the best breeding couples?
I hope they're keeping to the rules of the Institute. The animals are not being mistreated, I hope.
Absolutely not.
Rats are not a problem. You can do anything you like with rats. Boil them alive if you want to, but not the higher animals. No monkeys or dogs or rabbits. The highest beasts. There shouldn't be any of those on the premises.
There are no higher beasts there, I promise you.
It's infectious.
Good.
But obviously the best breeding couples will not be drawn from the poor and the degenerate in our society. There are people breeding who cannot support.
I hear that you are the very best they've got, you and another boy, but you are even better than his.
You heard that? From whom?
But don't pretend you didn't know. The very best.
I didn't know.
The cancer will be cured by...
Yes.
By 1959.
All forms of cancer?
No, it'll take much longer. Another 70 years, at least.
Many everyday diseases conquered. The familiar cold will be defeated undoubtedly by August 1940.
No. There will always be contagious diseases. Annihilate one, another will appear.
Diabetes. I'm not sure that that'll be solved. How to treat that? Not in this century.
Which century are we in?
But I disagree, you see, because I think that would be one of the first.
That was a very good short cut you gave me. There's no need to call me, sir.
Not yours. Reisner, you're being very quiet. Do you think we can make people live longer, healthier lives? Or will we always be degenerate?
I think to get even close to what will happen, we have to predict the wildest leaps of knowledge imaginable, then double those. The expectation of life over the next half a century will increase to 100 years, maybe 120, at least, I predict.
You can all go. Except Paul.
I approve of you, Reisner.
Thank you, sir. Thank you. And from relatively humble origins, too, aren't you? Scottish Jewish. Originated from Romania.
That's correct.
I think you may even have some flair. Don't, for heaven's sake, get more arrogant than you are already, will you? What do I say to that? You can try answering me this. How would you like to come and work with me? I assume that means yes.
sir. Only the things I've never done before. Dear Papa, we find ourselves immensely busy, with very little time for anything else, especially time to get home. Our accommodation has grown more luxurious. You would thoroughly approve, I'm sure. I've been seeing a little of the daughter of a Russian count in the very few hours I've had off. She is quite beautiful, rich, tempestuous.
She has large feet and lives in an enormous house in Richmond. His writing gets worse, but his news gets better. You must have some of our summer fruit this year, Mr. Willett. Come around and make your own selection.
Nasty little Jew.
We'll make our own selection for him. Woodland fruit. When he tastes those, we'll never get rid of him.
Just read the letter, Papa.
But the serious news, Papa, the first-class news, is my extraordinary good relationship with Professor Mandry. It improves with every day. My progress is truly surprising, Papa. I think it's likely I'll be judged top of the Institute, ahead even of my friend Felix. I'm no longer just a pupil of the professor, but a colleague, nearly a friend. I can say anything to him. He is a proud and a private man and a great man who takes an interest in all aspects of society. I'm privileged to be with him.
What a day. They go on producing children they cannot support.
I know.
Well, they can't be stopped by force.
No, of course not. No, Paul.
No, I mean, of course you couldn't do that. The only answer is education, and it is what you do best, isn't it, after all? Better than anybody in London.
According to whom?
According to you.
I don't think we should go back there for a while. Maybe we're working too hard, Paul.
That's more than possible, sir. I didn't think you'd come.
I know you didn't. But curiosity got the better of me.
This will seem very, very rude. In fact, practically the rudest and most inept thing anybody could ever do. Now, I got this not because I didn't think you looked nice, but because...
You didn't want me to show you up.
No. No, because I liked it so much. And... since I can't wear it myself. At least not tonight.
You're right. It is amazingly rude. It's also really quite nice. How did you know my size?
I used my medical knowledge. Told at a glance.
Let's see if you're right, shall we?
Right, I'm not waiting any longer.
Just 2 more minutes.
What are you going to do with our own dress, anyway? Where are you going to leave it?
Well, I don't know. Somewhere. In a cupboard, I
expect. In a cupboard?
In your room? You can't allow that.
No, 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 no. In the passage. Sure.
You were wrong, doesn't it?
Right.
Really? I can't have been wrong. It is hired, you know. That's the other unforgivable thing that I have to tell you.
Oh, I never thought you bought it. After all, you've no idea how tonight's going to turn out. Have you?
I've got to know, and I'm going to know, what are you working on?
What is it, Felix? If you value your life, you're going to tell me because you're pursuing something that nobody else knows about, aren't you? Aren't you? Deny it and you die.
I deny it.
It's about diabetes, isn't it?
Much more. Hormones, glands, everything, in fact. Each gland produces a substance.
A substance?
Listen, don't just moronically repeat things. Substance which is then released into the bloodstream, which then travels to a different part of the body where it takes effect. They all form a coordinating system, which they do.
But do they?
Yes. And what if there was one master gland in the brain that controls the functions of all the others? Which I believe I can prove it does. And also, I think I've found a way, given enough resources, to chemically isolate the internal secretions of the pancreas. And that would mean, of course, we could treat diabetes properly for the first time.
That's extraordinary, Felix.
It is revolutionary, yes, of course. But what do you think of it, Paul? Tell me.
I'm thinking. I'm not even going to say I'd wish I thought of it myself, because...
Because you couldn't have thought of it, Paul, that's why.
Because I have to be convinced it's even worth considering. At the moment, I am not convinced. What do you think, Clara? Oh, my God, Felix, look at the dress. I forgot about the dress.
Paul, it's nearly an hour now, for goodness sake. You've got to admit it's a great idea. You can't still be trying to convince yourself. Males then have to compete against each other for the right to mate? Will they wear amazing sexual shoes, like they used to in the Middle Ages? Will there be shoes to fight in, shoes even to kill with? Or will there be tolerance and gentleness, and even a little love? We are, of course, all tolerant now, aren't we?
Really like fish, isn't it?
Somebody's put a moving staircase, but the first one has already been exhibited in Paris this year.
I see, there's already one in Harrods. Oh, look, the famous men's corner. Professor Mandray. A drug to stop your hair falling out, that's not very good. Come on, I'll cap anything you think of. How about a tunnel under the Atlantic with vehicles speeding at 100 miles an hour?
How about free doctors? Oh. No, listen. A doctor on every train and bus in the morning to check the workforce.
This is the year of magic. What about balloon holiday villas?
Yes, it's floating on wires 2,000 feet above the city, so you can go for an aerial vacation.
What if all this came true?
I prophesy a visual telephone, a telephone with a picture. That would please my father.
But my idea is here now, Paul. You must be convinced. Well, stop thinking about her. I'm really surprised at you, Paul. She's so way beneath you. It's not worth it, you know, even for just one night.
The smell of summer. So warm. The last year of the century, and it's so hot. And I'm holding part of the city of the future in my hand.
Felix. I am convinced. Just now it happened. It's not very easy for me to admit because I thought I was going to be assessed top of the Institute, but if you let me, I'll work on it with you. Help you present it to Mandry.
All my ideas. It has to be all of them.
If you must, all of them. And I'm going to say something terribly dangerous and unoriginal.
But you're always unoriginal, Paul.
I was going to say this is the most exciting night of my life.
Yes, I really believe it is.
Oh, you've had better, I suppose.
I'm going to see myself home. I don't mind that much either way. But you can come.
It's down there?
Down there, yes. And there's no other way to get there.
I don't think I will, thank you. I have to talk to Felix.
Of course. I understand. Thank you for tonight. Would you like the dress back now?
Oh, don't be stupid, please.
I really hope you don't have to buy it now. Just remember, you had the chance.
Some of this is misspelled.
We must have written it down too fast. But...
And there's a great deal of it. What do you think, Reisner?
I think they are extraordinary ideas, which we should concentrate on with as many resources as possible. It could be something very important. I really mean this. Not just for us, but for the whole Institute. It will get serious attention from the newspapers.
At first glance, I have to say, they do seem rather intriguing, if not remarkable. I'll talk to you about this soon. In the meantime, don't mention it to anybody else.
This is Dr. Macon from the United States of America and Dr. Leisen from Germany. Good evening, gentlemen.
Sir,
soon, Paul. Very soon.
I read that paper by our mutual friend in Washington. I'm sorry to say I found it very poorly argued.
Unfortunately, that is often the case.
Professor Mandray, sir.
Oh, not just now, Reisner. This is not the moment.
Too many picnics.
That's the trouble with him.
Nothing yet. No news about Felix's idea at all.
But you mustn't be misled by that. Burridge always gives the impression that he's thinking deeply.
It's a talent I really must try to acquire. Seriously.
I don't know why you're not responding to our report, sir.
Not responding? What do you mean?
To our submission.
Well, there's a lot there, Reisner. This is the potentially interesting work I've received from Reisner and Russell. It's only been a few weeks, and I've had to read it three times so far. It is extremely novel.
I don't want to discuss this further in company. When I'm ready, you will hear from me. Be assured, I'm giving it my full consideration.
Is that why it's been kept in the broom cupboard?
That's why I couldn't find it the other day.
The cleaning arrangements have become ridiculously sloppy. I will look into the matter. You didn't leave it there, I presume.
No, I did not.
Good. I can get it back from you, can't I? Thank you.
With due respect, sir, I don't know why you seem to be deliberately not giving the ideas the consideration they deserve.
Paul, stop it, please. Don't do this.
That was unpardonable, Reisner. Everybody present knows that I have shown support for your ability, advanced you further than anyone at the Institute. I don't advise you to say another word on the subject. Do you understand?
I just feel that we are entitled to know why there has been such a delay. We're owed an explanation, sir.
Reisner, stand up, please. Go on, stand up.
You will not set foot in this building for one whole month. You will also receive no pay for that time. You will lose your laboratory. When you return, you must use the one you began in.
I don't want to see the slightest sign of you until then. Don't you dare try to reply to this. Just leave.
Where is Clara?
Not here.
Not here, but she's always here.
She's got a week's holiday. I don't know where she is.
Well, you must know.
She could have gone anywhere.
Well, where's her home? Her room. Where that she lives. What I mean is, I'm glad I've got the right address. You were very difficult to find.
Oh, I thought for a moment you were pleased to see me.
Of course I am.
Well, you must be in trouble of some kind, Dr. Reisner. We'd never have come.
It's just a little local difficulty with the professor. I overstepped the mark. Because I seem to be his favorite pupil, I thought I could. It's an easy mistake to make. Everything will come right, I'm sure, because, well, because he likes me. You steal all this equipment.
No, I did not. What do you take me for? I stole half of it. All the rest is cracked or wrong in some way. What are you doing?
Can I kiss you?
You may, Dr. Weiss.
You must stop calling me that. I've been waiting to do that ever since I saw you.
That is a total lie for a start. You're still not sure if you should be touching a laboratory worker. I think you'd like to be doing this wearing gloves. I still wish you were wearing gloves. Now you can see all of me.
I see no areas for real concern.
Thank you, Doctor. What about you? It's more to the point. I said I'd stop doing this. I really did. Especially with doctors.
Really?
Mm.
I couldn't possibly apply to this doctor.
Not now.
You are so vain. You really are. A doctor. There was only one. Something exotic I've made. We used to have a Chinese volunteer at the Institute and he taught me. This is Chinese food. Sort of Chinese food.
What peculiar looking stuff. Mmm. It's surprisingly edible. But a very quiet taste though.
Oh, you mean it only appeals to the very best palates, like yours, of course.
That's right.
Maybe you should give up medicine. Get a job sampling the foods of the future. They're opium addicts. They make a lot of noise. This area is full of bohemians and drifters. Doing terrible things without drawing the curtains.
I want to ask you one thing, Clara.
Just one.
Why is somebody like you...
Somebody as bright and intelligent as me... working in the bowels of the earth as a laboratory worker. Well, I mean, I can survive for very much longer unless I take your advice. Because I had a baby. And absolutely no husband. And no money. And then eventually there was no baby. It's a very normal story, really, except that I refuse to behave like some wretched, grateful creature who's lucky to be allowed into the Institute.
What happened to the baby?
I died. Caught influenza and 8 hours later it was dead.
Sorry.
I used to think it was the one thing in my life that I had created. It's wrong to think like that. Do you want to stay? You have to stay, don't you? You've got nowhere else to go.
Nowhere, that's right. I can't go home.
You should check the slides James has got, see they're being kept properly. Oh, and you should know the volunteers I'm particularly interested in, so maybe you can make some notes. You know, secret notes. If there have been any dramatic changes, bring them back to me.
I don't know what to look for. I have picked up some knowledge whilst being there.
All right now! All right now!
Oh, there you are. How is everything? Gotten it all yet?
Go away. We shouldn't even be seen talking.
You'll never catch up.
I'll surprise you when I get back. And the professor.
Can't wait.
You look wonderful in those clothes.
Yes. Why won't you tell me whose they are?
Because it's none of your business. Don't you start getting jealous.
Absolutely. I'll cook us a meal.
Go away!
I thought you might have come to the wrong address. But, very obviously, we have not.
What an extraordinary place to find you.
Yes, of course it is. But the explanation is simple.
Mary! Mary!
So? I tend these people. As a little extra service, a little medical care, and they allow me very kindly to wash myself here. Go on. And this room belongs to a woman, an elderly woman, who used to work at the Institute and now does some of her own research, as you can see, in her spare time. Once you've got a taste for it, it isn't easy to let it go.
And why are you dressed like that?
I find it easier to dress like them while among them.
Not a good policy, I can assure you.
Yes, Papa.
You look ridiculous, Paul.
Now let's forget about explanations. I will take us all out for lunch. Or maybe a cup of coffee would be best. The coffee in London is wonderful.
No.
What do you mean?
You are going to show me all around the Institute, of course.
That's totally impossible. It's shut.
Rubbish. Now put your shoes on, for God's sake. I can't bear to see you without shoes. And shave your face. And we'll be off right away.
So much dust.
That's good. For certain experiments. We need to make tests in all conditions.
Where is your bedroom and your bathroom?
Paul! What on earth are you doing here? Have you gone completely mad? Mandry's not falling, you know.
No, I just finished earlier than I expected. Felix is our resident eccentric. Take no notice. Come on, this way out. Come on.
Dr. Reisner?
There's a woman over there calling at you.
Yes, she does that to everybody. Take no notice of her.
Paul!
Take absolutely no notice of her.
Sir, good afternoon. Let me explain. I am not really here, sir. This is my father. He just wanted to see the Institute. I am not here.
I'm delighted to meet your father. Sir,
the pleasure is all mine.
A word with you, young man.
What did I say to you? I know, sir, but I have explained. I really do feel I have an excuse.
You've been away merely a week. Do you think I didn't mean what I said?
Well, of course you did. You think I'm a fool. My father insisted, really insisted, and it's incredibly difficult to stop him doing anything. If you knew him... I'm also very sorry I was so rude to you before. I had no business to sound like that.
That's quite gracious. Really quite an elegant apology. I would expect from you. I might even allow you back here sooner.
If you could, sir.
But you will have to realize that the matter of your research, your submission with Russell, that cannot be raised under any circumstances until I raise it.
It's a strange condition. When will that be, sir?
When it has been considered. No exact time limit can be put on it. There's nothing unusual in that.
But
Paul, I'm offering you another chance. It's not even your own work we're talking about here.
Sir, if you don't believe in the work, give it back to us. We can publish it elsewhere.
That's impossible. You know that all the work done here belongs to the Institute. You will have to realize that I will only allow you back here on these terms, and that is final. No further discussion is possible. you must listen to me.
Sir, I have to say, I do think it is a monstrous condition. You must give that work a chance. You really must.
If I could be certain that you and Russell could work on it quietly, and perhaps...
Quietly? Well, when?
One day, when it has been considered.
One day? One day? What does that mean? You're jealous, aren't you? Aren't you? You're far too good not to have seen the potential in that work. You are jealous of it because you didn't do it, and now you want to destroy it, and that is unforgivable.
Do you succeed? They are probably involved in deep conference.
Yes, Papa.
I'm sorry about the tone of what I said. That happens with me. I'm sorry. You have to accept that. But you must not delay this work.
It's too late, Reisner. You're finished here. If ever I see you again, and I mean this, I will make sure that you never work as a doctor anywhere again. You will also keep away from the other doctors here. I will not have you stirring them up. And I don't threaten lightly. As it is, you will never work in medical research again. That is over for you. I will see to it.
You can't do that,
Paul. Remember who you are. I shouldn't have to remind you what certain people think outside these walls. You have no contacts, nobody to help you. Just remember that. Now, I advise you to leave this room without saying another word.
You know I'm good. You know that. You liked me. I was even a favorite. We agree on so many things. Why are you doing this? I just can't believe you're being...
You see, you don't take my advice, do you, about anything? You arrogant boy. Get out of my sight. Out of the Institute. Go on!
No. I hope to see you again, Professor Mandry, very soon. You must come and visit us in the country. We have the most wonderful fruit this year.
A charming idea, Mr. Reisner. If I'm ever in your part of the world, I believe your son may have something to tell you. Just waiting
I
to
just
tell you.
I just wanted to say, oh, please, Diane, that my son has done so
you
well.
You just stop talking. Just stop talking.
Come on, you. Come, just come. We've got to go away from here.
Paul,
please,
what
stop.
What are you
just
doing?
Just go. We've got to leave. Paul. You should never have come.
Why on earth did you do that? I demand an explanation. What happened in there?
Did you argue?
You must never argue with him. What is it?
It's nothing like that.
Now, what is it?
I may be about to be promoted. My own research unit, maybe. It's a nerve-wracking time. I just didn't want you to complicate things by talking to him. You'll see. You'll see.
Take tea with me. Terrifying idea.
Who knows? I'm already like them, aren't I? That's how most people regard me. Clara's fallen over the edge.
You are all I've got now.
No, you don't. Don't you say that, because that is absolutely not what is happening, is it? You know perfectly well that as soon as your troubles are over, you will leave me very quickly.
No, I won't. Why on earth do you say that?
Because you are who you are.
You'll never be happy with someone like me. Can you see yourself introducing me to your father? Anyway, I don't expect anything, as long as you don't lie to me.
If I'm not allowed to use the word love, then I'm addicted to you, Clara. I am.
Neither of us can sleep.
You are incorrigible, Clara.
Oh, you see, you've started already. That must be some sort of grotesque, because I like sex rather a lot, and I don't pretend otherwise. Ah, you did it again. I'm not supposed to mention it.
You shouldn't talk about it, no.
You're not paying me rent after all. I do deserve some form of payment.
Before we start, if you can resist for one more moment, if that is physically possible, what do you think I should do next about Mandry, in your opinion?
If you insult people, you can beg forgiveness. It's simple. That's what you've got to do with the professor. You go down on your belly. But it will have to be right down. And say, I was wrong. About everything. And I'm not sure you can get down.
Get muddy in this city, didn't you know?
Well, it's ridiculous wearing these clothes. Look at this. How many times do you have to change a day? We should have overalls. Work in overalls to do research.
Overalls? He's gone insane, clearly, while he's been away. I know we work in a modern, eccentric place, but that's ridiculous.
You really are managing reasonably well, though. I'm in exile.
Yes. But, Felix, I'm thinking of retracting. Going to Mandry and saying I was wrong. I will never mention Felix's idea again. I solemnly swear it.
Don't worry. I've moved on to other things, other interesting ideas already.
You would have.
Well, it was too ambitious anyway.
I don't believe that.
We need you back, Paul.
We do. We do. It's undeniable, much as I'd like to deny it.
I remember going to one of his lectures when I was a student. It was actually very interesting. Mound of morning. What time were we expected?
I don't know. 10 minutes, quarter of an hour, or something like that.
Be careful. Oh, look who's coming. Take cover.
He didn't see me, did he? That's all I need. He'll think I'm plotting something if he saw me.
Is that the Yid's house? The one who's insulting us all in the local papers? Well, we don't want your sort telling us how to run our affairs. So my best advice to you is...
Shut up, you stupid little man. Go to the devil.
Another one?
Yes, it was. They always seem to call at tea time. We should get it taken away, Papa, the telephone.
No. It doesn't matter. Everybody gets them, these strange calls. It comes with the instrument. You earn one, and this is what happens.
If only you hadn't spoken to the local newspaper and said those things about the town being run by vegetables.
Come along. I want your help with the invitations to the New Year's party.
This party will never work. It'll make the last one look like a success.
I've had the invitation specially designed. What do you think?
Dr. Reisner? Yes. Dr. Paul Reisner? Yes, what is it? Would you come with us, please? We'd like to talk to you.
Talk to me?
Yes, sir. Just a little interview. Nothing to worry about, sir. Absolutely not.
An interview?
Yes, sir.
Not very far, sir. Not far at all.
Can you just tell me what this is about?
great Devonshire ball this weekend.
I can't say I...
What are you looking for, ladies?
Are you holding anything special for the celebration?
Good afternoon, Dr. Reisner. Please sit down.
Maybe it's your cup of yours. Yours? I thought it looked ghastly last night.
As you may be aware, there's a strong likelihood of this alien act coming into force very soon. Stop the flood of undesirable aliens we're having to endure at the moment. And we're just compiling a few documents of our own to be in readiness. Now, your father, despite having a German name, was in fact born in Romania.
I know where my father was born.
People often pretend they don't. Isn't that strange? Now, you were born in Scotland, then a short stay in America with your family as an infant, before you went back to Scotland, and at last came down south to us.
How do you know all this?
We just want to trace the journey that your family made, make sure all the correct procedures are followed at every stage.
This has all been arranged by him, hasn't it? By Professor Mandry.
He's probably at the ball as well.
This is the result of a personal vendetta. You have no legal rights to do this. Your job does not entitle you to detain me in these circumstances for a single moment, as you well know. Goodbye, gentlemen.
You bastard!
Don't you dare tell us how to do our job.
No, no, gentlemen, please. Let's have none of that. If you want to leave, Dr. Reisner, please do. It's only our first meeting, after all. We'll be seeing each other again.
What on earth have you been doing? You all right? What did you run into?
Just something Mandry arranged for me. I think it can be safely said he truly hates me.
Do you trust me? You have to trust me.
I don't. What is that stuff? I've never seen it before.
It's something we use at the Institute. It was developed there.
I'm the doctor and I've never heard of it.
Well, you see, you don't know everything. Come on. Brave boy. It's all right. I know what I'm doing.
This stuff will never become popular. I ought to get back to being a doctor, Clara. You can't stop me being a doctor everywhere. To you. All been sterilized. Some of this has been very clumsily done. I've suffered terrible harm. this to you. Who was it? You must tell me.
The Ed one, the one that came with you. He said he'd give us an operation to make us not get ill.
Has the same thing happened to these women?
I cannot believe a man like him would do this.
I know.
They wouldn't have known what was happening to them. The underclass must be stopped from breeding. Does that mean we kill them? Good inherited characteristics should be encouraged, bad inherited characteristics eradicated. Otherwise, we will be overrun by the degenerate. Worthless genes must be prevented from spreading.
The feeble-minded should be sterilized, never allowed to breed. This is from an American journal about eugenics.
I mean, he never paid attention to this rubbish. He knew this was just for cranks and ladies' discussion groups and a few very conservative scientists. He had contempt for all of this, Clara. Total contempt. He thinks somehow he is taking action over the population problem. He must think he's conducting some kind of controlled experiment with those people on the rubbish heap, choosing who can breed. He's probably working on another group now.
He must have just been starting that sterilization program when you came rushing in with Felix's idea.
He lied to me. He knew what I thought.
We'll never be able to prove it anyway. They'll just say
the women gave their consent, I know.
And you can never tell what those sort of people want.
I'm going to stop him, Claire. Find witnesses.
Oh, just think for a minute, Paul. You can't even get near him.
I am going to get him.
It's not going to work. Dr. Leeson's in there and there are other people. We can't get by them.
You can't come in here. You're never going to come in here again.
Not here too. Everybody's already having a party. I'm very sorry, Katie.
I wasn't looking forward to it much anyway, sir.
He gives a lecture. A Christmas lecture. He does. He must. Everybody does. He'll be in public.
Machines to do the work now done by our gardeners. Machines to put our children to bed at night. Machines to tell the little darlings bedtime stories. Machines that can advise us of the latest.
Good luck.
I need it. We need it. I don't think I've dreaded doing something so much in my whole life. Do you think I can do it?
Of course we can do it.
I'll speak and then you speak. If you forget anything, don't worry. I'll prompt you very calmly. There'll be no hurry once we start.
Will we have long, spidery hands that can touch and caress these machines into life? Because everything will be done by machines. And our strength, will we need our strength anymore? Will we possess eventually beautiful, drooping limbs that can flick and twist knobs? Our toes will be used to switch machines on and off, to order them around. What about women? Could women ever develop differently in this respect? women who are already beginning to make quite a noise for themselves.
Any moment.
Could they evolve into the physically stronger sex? Should we even worry about that? Will they become dominant, as in some other animal species? More seriously, and in conclusion, should we worry about physical degeneracy at all in our society? Because we all realize that it's happening. There are so many diseases that we haven't conquered, contaminating whole sections of the population. How difficult is it to stop this cycle? When we are constantly creating an underclass that cannot support itself and yet continues to multiply regardless. Or should we try to plan and influence nature to control and use science to improve the society that we are giving birth to?
Hear, hear.
But these are such weighty questions. I think we need to resort to something that we have created in the Institute to help us solve. Created in this very building in our laboratories here. And highly delicious it is, too. The white weather present to all of you.
I missed the moment, and then I don't know, I wasn't brave enough. I saw him there and I thought, I really like him. He looks so good.
I'm glad. I don't think I could have done it either.
It's not fair on you, Casey, I know.
Don't worry about that. I just don't like being here. I couldn't have done it.
Oh, there you are! When are you coming back? When are you, Paul? Paul!
There'll be another chance for this, I'm sure. Paul.
When?
Sorry, Papa, I didn't realize you were in here.
Not at all, come in, my dear.
Is everything all right, Papa?
Everything is absolutely splendid. As always.
As always.
Please, wait. Mrs. Whiteweather. Just for a moment, please.
I do not possess a moment. I'm going to the theater.
Don't you remember me? We had tea. I was covered in dust.
Oh, yes, yes. Yes, I remember you perfectly. You're quite proud of that particular. Special Christmas gift. Now, you have 45 seconds.
I don't know if I can do it in the time. It's about the Institute. Everything is going wrong. Professor Mandray, while ignoring important work...
What important work?
Well, it doesn't matter the exact nature. I can't explain this in the time, but...
Oh, you think I'm stupid? You think I wouldn't understand?
No, it's just a little technical. I shouldn't have mentioned it.
I heard something else about you, I believe. You're the one with the foreign name, aren't you? Reisenberg. I must say you don't look it particularly. Then nowadays one can never tell. I am not anti-Semitic myself. Though some of my friends have their own opinions.
I'm starting again from now, you understand? Professor Mandry, the head of your husband's institute is sterilizing people without their consent. People living roughly near the city, poor people, some very young. Many have been sterilized and some have died, yes. Professor Mandry has become deeply involved with eugenics, improving the genes and preventing certain people from having children.
If Mr. Mandry sees it as part of his work, so be it.
But he is sterilizing people against their will while pretending to give them medical care.
Well, how do you know? How do you know it's against their will? They no doubt gave their consent.
No, I have witnesses.
They are probably trying to get money. Everybody now is trying to get money. You're growing tiresome, young man. This is a time of celebration. Didn't you know?
People have died. Directly or indirectly, they have been killed.
Well, people are dying all the time, unfortunately. I sometimes think medicine is killing as many people as it cures. Now your time is over, young man.
No, please, you must listen to me. Because I know you wouldn't like what is happening. I know that.
Don't you dare tell me what I'm thinking or feeling. Now I know why you lost your place at the Institute. Now then, let's be on our way. I have to change for the theater.
You know he's using monkeys to experiment on. Professor Mandry. He is, and dogs. Hire animals. I should take a look if I was you.
What did you say? Monkeys and dogs? Is that what you said?
Dr. Russell, when are we to be treated, sir?
So kind. Join me in a drink.
Of course, sir.
Tell me, have I ever shown any prejudice towards you? Tell me honestly.
Of course not, sir. Less than anyone I've ever met. I mean, not at all. You've always encouraged me.
Good. I hoped you were going to say that.
You see, James, it is my job to be aware of the problems of the future, to be ahead of the current thinking. And sometimes that is a difficult job, because so few people are equipped to do it. At the moment, so very few.
And we have to fight for this place.
You can't take those papers. Those are mine, my own work, give them back. Did you see what you've done?
Yes, I'm sorry, but you know what we found out. It had to be like this.
You sound so smug. You had no proof. No proof at all.
I did, Felix.
I hope this isn't purely your revenge because he threw you out.
You know that's not the reason, Felix. You can't believe that.
Does your father know what you've done?
I telephoned my sister, but I can't tell my father. One day he'll know.
I'd wait to spend New Year's Eve. New century's coming and we're here. Now, I haven't even got a party to go to now. What's going to be my hair? Look at it. The most important New Year's Eve for 100 years. Nowhere to go.
come down with me. Come to my father's party. Please come, Felix. I would love that.
Your father's party.
Yes.
You see what you did? You hesitated. Already it's starting.
All right, don't do this! It's not true. I promise I'll prove it to you. You've got to come. You have to be with me tonight of all nights.
I do, do I? Paul, it hurts so much. You're not that much different to the professor, really, when it comes down to it.
No, don't say that. Must still be in this building somewhere.
Pleased with yourself?
Oh, don't you start to.
This place meant a great deal to me, more than you can imagine.
I'm sorry. I'm very sorry, James. Where is he? He must be nearby. His things are still here.
He set off for a New Year's Eve party, the one that he's chosen. He was invited to nearly every party that matters in London, and many outside.
Really? So which one has he picked?
Oh, you don't know. Your father's. He had a mission to accomplish.
Of course. He would do that, wouldn't he? Too vulgar. Far too vulgar.
Can you see him? Here they come.
What
What's he all dressed like that for?
To show them Papa is some sort of sea monster. Doesn't he look good? And I'm some sort of mosquito sucking blood and biting people. I can bite people all night if I want. It's to show them all we don't care if they come or not.
This is Clara, who is who I hope.
What do you hope?
Delighted to see you. You must be cold like that. We met once in a basement full of rats, remember? You must come and see this now. You see, we're going to have to move. Leave this house.
Move? Why?
There's no business for Papa in this town. They're all boycotting him. He can't get any building work.
Why didn't he tell me? Why on earth didn't he say?
They want to drive him out of town, and they've succeeded.
They can't do that. They can't. This is turning into a great night.
I'm sorry about everything going wrong in London. For you, I mean.
Yes. I have come to see that man. Where the hell is he?
Papa, you look truly bizarre. And rather wonderful.
I do not dare catch a glimpse of myself in case I lose my nerve and take it all off. On the boat, I was worried in case I saw my reflection in the water. Your poor mother. Your poor dead mother. She would never have approved of me dressed like this. But, Paul, you don't know. There will be wonderful news. Who on earth do you think is honoring us tonight? Who is at my party?
I know, Papa.
Shouldn't have come here. I must ask you to leave immediately. You understand now?
Is that all you have to say to me? It's New Year's Eve. You did what you thought was right. I understand that, but you can't stop progress.
Progress, is that what it's called?
And you are intelligent enough to know that progress can initially be unpleasant. An approach has to be found.
Why are you here, anyway?
I was invited by your father. And I wanted to see you. We couldn't leave it messy and disagreeable between us. I'm fond of you, Paul. Of course, I would quite like you to retract what you said, say that you were mistaken, so that funds can return to the Institute. I want to explain.
You can't explain. I know. But remember?
Then let the Institute continue without that work. You must think about it. I need that place. I really do. Paul, do this for me. We agree on so much.
You may have forgotten, Professor Mandrew, but you tried to get me thrown out of this country, tried to turn me into an undesirable alien.
I was angry with you for a time because you wouldn't listen. And you were angry with me, too. But that's over.
We belong as much as you do. Say it. We belong. Say it. Go on. Say it!
Of course, Paul. You belong. But it's New Year's Eve. We should.
Will you get up, Professor Mandry, and go from here? I am not going to ask you again.
Well, let's leave this for a while then. Your father thinks everything is absolutely splendid. Why spoil his night? It's very important to him. Let us enjoy your father's party.
Don't talk to him anymore, Paul. Get out.
I just... I won't be a moment.
Please go on about the machines of the future. Will there be shops in the moon?
Will we be able to eat strawberries then?
Well, help me collect these papers first, then I'll tell you. My ideas are here. Just collect those.
Did you write this?
Yes, yes, I did. These are my ideas, you see.
Marianne has just told me the unbearable news. Can it be true?
Papa, yes. I closed the Institute. I arrived to conquer London to be the very top of the Institute, and I ended up being responsible for it being shut down. Some achievement. That's what your son did.
But I don't know. It's difficult to believe that a man of such distinction, such a good man in so many ways, could do such a thing. You will have to work hard to persuade me that you were right. Paul, I don't want to talk about it anymore tonight. It's such a business, and he is a guest in our house.
And this is Clara, a laboratory worker from the Institute. I have been living with her for the last few months.
Clara, it is New Year's Eve. I may be dead tomorrow. Possibly I will be. And it's raining at my pub. What is happening tonight?
Look at those bastards. They were all going to boycott the party, but they couldn't keep away. They came out of curiosity to gloat on. They don't know what to do. They don't. But you can't leave this town, Papa. You can't let them win. I might even stay here a while myself. They look so unhealthy, there'll clearly be plenty of work.
Gentlemen,
your very good health, sir. Thank you very much, sir.
We won't forget each other, Paul.
Clara, will you stay here with me? Decide before midnight. Tell me.
It won't work. It's not going to work between us, Paul.
You don't know that. You don't know.
I do know.
No, you don't. You would keep everything. You would keep control over your life. Yes, you would be the same Clara.
It won't work.
Say you don't know for sure. Say it before midnight.
I do know very surely.
No, you can't be so sure. You used to love me a little, I know. I shouldn't use that word, but I am. I will.
There'll be moments when I've been terribly in love with you, Paul.
Only moments.
You are so vain!
Say it, Clara. Say you don't absolutely know it won't work. Say it before midnight. No, I'm not going to let you go.
So that I don't absolutely know it won't work.
It will work, my love.
My God, I don't know why I am crying. All the things I've never done in my life. Will there be time? I don't know. Will it be better? What will happen? Well, it has been some party, hasn't it? It has been a great party, hasn't it? At least.
Felix, a prediction.
We will be able soon. We will. I don't know.
Happy New Century!
My father was obviously given a tremendous boost by this party, because he lived for almost another 20 years. Felix did some very fine work on diabetes a few years later, but I remain convinced if that year had gone differently, he would have been the first to discover insulin. Often at night, I still think about the professor and about the dark turning he took in his work. I never saw him again, and I don't think he ever went back to medicine. Some say he killed himself one summer in a little seaside town. Others that he died peacefully. He still remains, in many ways, the most brilliant man I've ever met. For years, I found myself hoping that one day I might meet him in the street. That I'd see that tall figure coming towards me again. Clara and I, we never got married. She insisted on remaining my common law wife. She is sitting across the room now as I dictate this. We worked together for many years in a quiet country practice. We have fought a lot, of course, during that time, but that was only to be expected. Nothing in my life, though, has ever quite equaled the strange feeling I had that night. Excited and worried and hopeful as we moved together into a new century.